Hi, Earth Science students. It was great meeting you at our first face-to-face meeting this morning. Right now, I'm going to show you how to get started on Edgenuity. Edgenuity is going to be our learning management system for this class and for all of your classes at Redlands eAcademy. Check your email. I sent your username and password to you so you can log in. Now that you have your login, let's go ahead and get started. In the address bar, enter learn.edgenuity.com/student. It's a good idea to bookmark this site since you'll be using it daily. Before we start, check to make sure all of your plugins are up to date. This will help make sure that Edgenuity will run smoothly and not cause any problems. Click the Check Plugins button now. All of mine should be up to date. And they are. So once you have that, if you don't see any red X's, we can go ahead and log in. Go ahead and put your username and your password in and press the login button. I'm going to do that now. Go ahead and press enter. Once you log in, a menu screen will pop up. Over here on the left-hand side, you will see the list of courses that you're currently enrolled in. Over on the right, you'll see three tabs. You have the My Course Info, Communications, Sign Out, and then you also have this little special organizer one over here, and we'll talk about those in a few minutes. Click the My Course Info tab. This shows information about the course that you have selected. It gives the percentage of class that is completed and your overall grade for the course. It also shows colors to show you how you are keeping up with the pace of your course. If it shows red up here, you're behind. If it shows blue, you're right on target, and if it's showing green, you're ahead of schedule. Now, click the Communications tab. Here you can read about the announcements, read emails for me, or also chat with students or myself. Next, the Sign Out tab does just that. It allows you to sign out of Edgenuity. And off to the right, you have the Organizer buttons. When you click it, a window pops up. Go ahead and click that button now. Down at the bottom, you have some buttons. You have Reports, Communication, Resources, Back, and Power. Go ahead and click Reports. The Reports feature allows you to check feedback on your assignments, view progress reports, read your notes, and view your assignment calendar. Now, click the Communication button. This allows you to communicate with students and teachers through email and chat. It also has a collaboration corner button where you will work on projects with other students. Now, click the resources button. Here are other tools for you to use to keep track of your PE hours, check your plugins, or if you need some help with something else on Edgenuity, you can go ahead and click the orientation or how to. Hit the power button, and now everything will close. Now, I'm going to get you started on your first lesson. Go back to the My Course Info tab if you are not already there. At the bottom, you can click on Course Map. It will give you detailed information about what is upcoming in the class. You can access lessons in the class by clicking on the blue text with the lesson name on it. Since we are just starting the class, we will start out with the Introduction to Earth Science under the planet Earth. Click the blue What is Science link on the left-hand side of the page. On the right, click the vocabulary link and it will take you to our first lesson. I've already completed this lesson, but normally you'll only see the next lesson that you are able to complete. Vocabulary. Okay, that'll pop up. For this lesson, we're working on vocabulary. You will need to type the word and then you can listen to the definition of the word and the word being used in a sentence by clicking on the orange circle with an arrow in it. So I'm going to go ahead here, type science, and then I'm going to press play on the definition. Click the box and then, or the circle, and the definition will play in the background. Same thing you can do with the usage, it'll use the word science in a sentence. I've already completed all this, so I'm just going to flip through real quick. You'll have to type the words and listen to the definitions as you go. Okay, now that you've finished, you have the finished with the word scientific theory. When you're all complete, go ahead and click next activity. Okay, your next direct lesson is going to pop up. This one is called What is Science? Your next lesson is a direct instruction video. As you watch the video, you can click on the orange plus over on the top right hand side of the screen. Here you'll be able to take notes on the lecture, look at the glossary terms, and also be able to read the transcripts of what the teacher is saying. While you are watching the videos, take the time to write down the important ideas in your own words. They will help you with the quizzes and tests. Now you can close the notes and move the mouse to the bottom of the video. Here, you'll be able to adjust the volume of the video. Right here, you'll be able to add the captioning to any of your videos. Unfortunately, this one does not work. You can also, once you watch the video, you're able to fast forward to different parts of the video and rewind it. Until you watch the video the first time, you won't be able to fast forward, you can only rewind. So now, I'm going to let you continue on your own. After you watch this video, you'll click the next button to continue on with the lesson. If you want to go back to the main screen at any time, hit the little home button at the top left part of the screen. That's what I'm going to do now. And before I finish up, I just want to give you a few tips to help make you a successful online student. Tip number one, take good notes on the videos. Put the main ideas into your own words. This will help you on the quizzes and the tests. You can take notes using the e-notes that's provided with Edgenuity, or just use pen and paper. Number two, stay on pace with the class. Don't fall behind. It'll be difficult to try and catch up. Number three, check your assignment calendar daily. That'll also help you make you stay on top of all of your assignments. Number four, ask for help when you need it. I may be able to help clear up any confusing information, or I can give you a source that may help you. Good luck with your first week's assignments. Don't hesitate to ask if you have any questions.